I gave you my heart.
Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome to another edition of Noble Sports Entertainment. If this is your first time stopping by the channel on today, I'd like to welcome you to this channel. I'd like to thank you for stopping by. Make sure you guys subscribe to this channel, because on this channel we talk sports, period. Click that bell icon and push the word all that you may be able to receive every upload and notification that comes from Noble Sports Entertainment. Also, make sure you subscribe to the DSA. Their links will be below in the description box. All right, guys, I want to talk a little bit about the Lakers on today. And the reason why I want to talk about this team, because the Lakers have been playing phenomenal. I've been watching a lot of their games, and this is my take on the Lakers so far. Dwight Howard has been the X factor on the team, playing excellent defense, giving them what they need off the bench. And he has been nothing less than phenomenal for the Lakers. And he's really been playing for these guys. But the Lakers win last night. They get the win, so that's 7 wins in a row for the Los Angeles Lakers, beating the Miami Heat, who came in very hot. Miami has really been balling, and the Lakers finally hand them another loss in the loss column. But at the same time, LeBron James and AD have been box office, and they've been lights out together pretty much right now. Until Paul George gets back to the Clippers. Right now, AD and LeBron James is the number one duo in the NBA right now. You got Anthony Davis playing at an all-time high with on defense, and giving them what they need on defense, as well as giving it to them on the offense. Now, he struggled in that Chicago game a little bit, but we know that Anthony Davis is always going to pick up his lunch pail and go to work. And AD has been balling. LeBron James has been phenomenal. LeBron will be 35. In December, and he's getting a little bit older now, but at the same time, the dude still has it, and he still has been doing his things out there with the latest of him going with 3 triple doubles back to back to back, and finally last night just having a nice game and just picking and choosing his shots against the Miami Heat. But at the same time, him and AD, 26 and 25 points. The Lakers end up beating the Miami Heat. The final score was 95-80. End up beating them by 15. And the Lakers' defense, they've pretty much been the number one thing. And both of these guys, I think that AD had brought a sense of urgency for the defensive side of the ball. You know, you got guys like Avery Bradley, who's a very good on-the-ball defender, who has been playing phenomenal for the Lakers. And then you got Alex Caruso has been doing pretty good, but I still think with Kyle Kuzma, it's going to take him a couple more games to really get his feet up under him. You know, Kyle has been out for a while, and now he's trying to get acclimated to the rest of the team. And I just think that he needs time to play at least 10 or so games to get under his belt with LeBron and AD. But I definitely think that Kuz has an opportunity to average around 17 or 18 off the bench for the Lakers when he finally gets his feet back up under him. Now, KCP has been up and down with the Lakers. He has not had a he has not really stood out, you know. And I know a lot of people have been talking about KCP not standing out on the bench, and that the Lakers bench would probably be their trouble when it comes to the postseason. So I don't know if the Lakers will eventually try to trade and try to get a Andre Iguodala, or hope that the Memphis Grizzlies will let him go and buy him out. But right now, the Grizzlies are content on trying to trade Andre Iguodala instead of just letting him go and walking. They're really going to try to trade this guy. And there's been a lot of news about Andre Iguodala possibly going to the Clippers or the Lakers. Any of those teams that Iguodala goes to, he would definitely help those teams out. And definitely a championship would be on the Clippers or the Lakers' mind if they get a Andre Iguodala to come off the bench for them. Because we know that he has been solid. And not only that, Andre Iguodala has been a finals MVP before with the Golden State Warriors, coming off the bench for those guys and playing well for them when they had the championship run. We know that the Golden State Warriors are not the same Golden State Warriors anymore. Due to injury with Klay Thompson, and due to injury with not only Klay Thompson, but also Steph Curry, who just broke his hand. So The Lakers have been playing some phenomenal basketball right now, guys. And it's awesome, man. It's awesome to see. It's awesome that there's no drama going on right now. Everybody's been doing their job and playing their part. And Dwight Howard has been phenomenal for the Lakers, coming off the bench, blocking shots, defending well, rebounding well, and just giving them whatever points they can get. Whatever they can get from Dwight Howard, I know that that's what they are going to take, whatever they can get. And he has been phenomenal, man. And that's what you need. But Rajon Rondo is expected to be back on Sunday, which is going to be good for the Lakers because they definitely need Rondo to be able to orchestrate the offense in that second unit. And I definitely think that Rondo is more than capable of getting those guys in their sweet spots and being able to do the things that they need to have done. Now, the Lakers, for the most part, you know, going on a 7-game win streak after losing to the Clippers. You know, the biggest challenge that I see so far for the Lakers is going to be Kawhi Leonard and the Clippers. The Clippers play elite defense, and the Lakers are going to have to be up for the challenge. I believe that both of these teams play again for the Battle of LA Part 2 on Christmas. So this is going to be really, really good game for everybody to be able to watch and look to see how these guys are going to go at one another. But I definitely think that the Lakers have what it take to finally get a W against the Clippers. It's not going to be easy because Paul George will be back. So it's really going to be the Battle of LA. So I can't wait to see how that's going to transpire on Christmas Day. But right now, the Los Angeles Lakers are playing their best basketball. And I got to give a shout out to the Lakers for handling their business. So we'll see how this thing plays out. All right, guys, make sure you subscribe to Noble Sports Entertainment, because on this channel, we talk sports, period. Peace. I gave you my heart.